Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nos programmes offrent plusieurs langues. Veuillez visiter suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Visiten suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Нашите предавания предлагат много езици. Моля вижте suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Please watch on for Prophecy of the Golden Age, Part 107, The Great Saint in the Chinese Prophecies.
Today's program will be presented in Chinese and English, with subtitles in Arabic, Alexis, also known as Vietnamese, Bulgarian, Chinese, Czech, English, French, German, Hindi, Hungarian, Indonesian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Persian, Polish, Portuguese, Punjabi, Romanian, Russian, Spanish, Telugu, and Thai.
Ning hao, you the guanzhong, wo shi yue shen changxi.纵观人类历史，神圣的讯息常笼罩在神秘的事物中。先知、弥赛亚，无论你怎么称呼他们，他们常受迫害与压迫，他们的话隐晦不明。但我们如何分辨真假？要做到这点，人们只能仰赖上天的引导。 而真理将向那些认真寻求他的人揭示。先前我们开始探索中国知名预言家刘伯温所写的 金陵塔碑文，碑文描述了即将降临世界的大平年，以及在此之前的苦难。金陵塔碑文还提到一些具体的灾难，例如核辐射。 繁华城市被海水淹没，高楼大厦变成泥堆，而且亲人尸横遍野，万物都遭殃，连虫和蚂蚁也逃不过这场夺命浩劫。
如今我们确实或多或少目睹了这些事件。
清气动山岳，一线铁难当。繁华事变汪洋，高楼阁变泥缸。父母死难埋葬，爹娘死儿孙扛。万物同遭劫，虫蚁亦遭殃。
Because of this time cleaning as well, yeah?
Yes.
Cleaning the whole planet, eh?
Yes, yes, Master.
Yeah. All this is just cleaning, you know, and warning, but human, if don't change, then it's going down.
幸得大木两条支大厦。
这句诗文告诉我们，事情仍存有希望，因为有两只大木柱支撑着这座大厦，
使它不至于完全倒塌。
刘伯温指的就是这位救世圣人。
大木两条可能是指这位大圣人生于松柏暮年，而且方位是在属木的东方。在二十世纪，唯一的松柏暮年是1950年和1951年，而青海无上师的生辰正好落在1950年和1951年之间，而且他出生于优乐。优乐又称为越南，是一个东方国家。青海无上师确实像一只大柱一样支撑着我们的星球和世界，这座大厦使它不会全面崩塌。
Our planet would have been destroyed long ago. Our world would have ceased to exist if we have not had many benevolent, compassionate masters who came and went during all our history of humankind.
Yes, Master.
Yeah, and even now, even if there is no practitioner, no master's power to uphold this planet, it would be gone, okay? Because the sin of 7 billion people are too great, too heavy. It's shaken heaven and earth.
Yeah.
it pierces all hearts of devas and deities everywhere in the whole universe.
Niao fei yang zou fan jia bang.
这句诗文指出飞鸟和羔羊都会回家，可以解释为这位大圣人将度化众生回天堂，超三界，使他们不再经历生、老、病、死和轮回之苦。
因此，解脱的鸟儿终于脱离轮回而高飞，羔羊也安全地被带回自己的羊群。这就像圣经里主耶稣基督所讲的预言，他在预言中以牧羊人找到一只迷途羔羊的喜悦来比喻，即使只有一位罪人悔改并得到灵性的救赎，天堂也会很高兴。这是否也在描述一个蓬勃发展的纯素世界，所有动物脱离苦难，重获他们天赐的尊严？我们祈祷，但愿如此。
能逢木兔方为寿，则集群生乐且康。
这段预言清楚告诉我们，
只有那些
认识这位大圣人才能得寿，这意味着他们能活下来，
而且或者
他们的灵魂能得救，那是因为这位大圣人
会加持那些相信他的人。木又指生于暮年，兔则象征这位大圣人是温润的纯素食者。
Of course, I can bless the people who are.Repenting and turn to benevolent way of life. I can bless by the grace and mercy of God Almighty. I have told you already that I help the souls who are repentant, even though they have to die, to redeem their sin. I help them if they are repentant in their heart, if they have ever seen my photo,or my video or my talk and have some reverence or some belief in me. These I can help.
Anytime they can U-turn now and I will be standing by. If they can U-turn, of course, they will have somehow more protection. But it also depends on how much merit they have as well, okay?
Yes, Master.
Combine that with their previous life merit and their sincerity and their humble prayers and repentance, that would help somehow.
Yes, Master.
At least if they cut the pandemic, it will be milder, it will be lessened, yeah? And if they die, I could find excuse to help their soul to go up to heaven.
Yes, Master.
有人识得其中意，富贵荣华百世昌。
先知说，只有那些真正理解碑文含义，并按照这位大圣人指示过生活的人，才能安然度过这些灾难，并得享富贵荣华百世昌。
难道这是意味着听从这位大圣人的话就能致富或成名吗？
在这则寓言的结尾，我们找到了这句诗文的真正含义，内容如下：
层楼垒阁耸云霄，车水马龙竞嬉笑，浅水鲤鱼终有难，百载繁华一梦消。
刘伯温的这几行结语
清楚提醒了我们，我们身处的世界虚幻无常，无论我们是否住在耸入云霄的高楼大厦，或过着喧嚣热闹的世俗生活，我们终将如搁浅的鲤鱼般面临麻烦。人生不过百年，无论我们多富有，当死亡来临时，物质的一切将如梦一般消失。
尤其是处在灾难时期，我们的世界最近不断遭到天灾人祸。
Don't be too comfortable in this world, okay? It will leave you. Whatever you do in this world, it will leave you. You will leave it behind, it will leave you. So just do what you can, yeah? But remember that, okay? Important is soon to go out of this world. And what will you take with you? Nothing but spiritual merit and good deeds. That's the only thing you can take with you.Remember that very well. I'm serious.
From《金陵塔碑文》中，也许我们学到的主要教训是，我们应看透世俗世界，并把握宝贵的机会，实践这位大圣人的教理。的确，我们这些青海无上师的弟子们都已体会到师父恩赐的通往开悟的观音法门，正引领我们迈向先知所颂扬的永恒的富贵荣华。但愿世人同样享有这份永恒的保护，尤其身处在这些充满不确定的时期中。
We busyJust existing here, and we forgot that the source of all strength, the source of all blessing, the source of all richness is within us. And once we can get hold of the source, we will have everything. I'm going to show you how to do just that. Get in touch with your treasure. Just like the Bible say that, lay not your treasure upon earth,where the moth can destroy, but lay your treasure in heaven, where it will last forever. I'm going to show you the everlasting treasure, if you care to know.
谢忠实的观众今天的观赏，
下周请再度收看本节目，来了解刘伯温的《烧饼歌》中关于这位圣人救主更多耐人寻味的寓言。
焦点新闻后接着播出
《圣者奥罗宾多》，素食者专注于神圣觉醒的整体瑜伽二级之一。
请锁定无上师电视台，愿您那边以及世界各地都闪耀着黄金时代的光。
Thank you, gracious viewers, for your company today. Please tune in again next week for more highly interesting predictions about the Saint Savior from Neil Bowen's The Baked Cake Ballad. Coming up is Sri Aurobindo, Vegetarian, Integral Yoga for Divine Awakening, Part 1 of 2, right after Noteworthy News. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television. May the light of the Golden Age shine within you and throughout our world.
Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule and suprememastertv.com/AP.